My name is Madhusudhan, actually born in Alosta. Many people have asked me the question, actually, why am I called teddy bear doctor? And most of them, 99% of them, think it's because of my size that I've been called a teddy bear. But actually, I don't mind being called a teddy bear. I kind of like the name. It was actually when I was in Kechara Soup Kitchen, I used to have lots of teddy bears in the car. And whenever I see a child on the street, I used to give them a teddy bear. So happened there was a reporter when one of this child saw me coming from a distance and she shouted, "Hey, the teddy bear doctor is coming." So that is how I got the name. My father is a doctor. My elder brother is a doctor. My younger brother refused to become a doctor, so he became a software engineer. And my younger sister is a pharmacist. My mom assists my dad in the clinic also. I've seen my father doing a lot of voluntary jobs. He gives free treatments for the patients who come to the clinic, whoever is poor and whoever cannot afford medical treatment. I think so. It was either late secondary school or early college life when me and my friends, we visited an orphanage home near school. We didn't have any money to spend on the kids because we were still students at that time. So what we could do was spend our time with the children. And we realized that the little time we spent on that, we could bring lots of smiles on the faces of the children. So we decided, okay, we should do more. And since then, we had visited a lot and lots of orphanage home, lots of old folks home. We made it a point to make a visit to old folks home or orphanage home every few months. When I started a Teddy Mobile Clinic more than a year ago, there was only me and my elder brother, the doctor, and 6 to 8 volunteers. We set up a table, just one table, another table for registration, and we started seeing the patients on the streets. And it has grown to an extent where we have roughly about 50 volunteers every week, and about 5 to 6 doctors persistently coming almost every week. Unless they are busy, they have something to do, they won't come. We initially started at one location, which was only at Segi, in front of Segi College, Hang Le Kew. And now we have opened a second location, which is at Masjid Negara. At the mobile clinic, we usually see roughly about 40 to 50 patients a week. But there are times they are lesser, or sometimes they are more. My volunteers mean everything to me. They're actually like my family. It's difficult to know who's homeless during the daytime because they are dressed up like a normal person. They are seen walking on the streets like a normal person with a bag. It's only on the nights, usually after 11 to 11:30 p.m., when most of the shops are closed. That's when they come out, they drag a piece of box, a few pieces of paper, lay it on the ground and sleep. So actually, there's a very big group of homeless in KL. There's more than thousands of them in KL. Some of them are working, but they cannot afford to stay in a room. Because probably, you see, a room in KL is minimum 400 to 500 ringgits. Okay, whereas their pay is only about 1,000 to 1,200 ringgits. So instead of spending and wasting the money on the room, they rather send the money back to their family and they live on the streets. So there are many public toilets around KL which they use to take bath, change their clothing and get to work. And in the night, they are back on the streets. These people should not be neglected. They are human too. They do need our care. They do need our love. Their dignity level is very low. Okay, they feel very neglected by the society. The reason why they don't seek treatment from hospital is they feel that they are very inferior to most of us. Even though they are human, okay, they feel that they lack attention from people and they do not like to be seen in public. Because of the discrimination, people may say, "Hey, you are homeless, what are you doing here?" Although this medical care is supposed to be free for everyone, not only for the poor community, but also for the homeless community. It brings all the volunteers lots of happiness by helping these people. Just a slight smile from them is enough to make us continue doing what we are doing. I can say I'm selfish, I can say my friends are selfish because we don't know who's happier, who's happy by doing this. Either they are happy by getting our help or we are getting more happier by helping them. So it's a give and take situation, yeah.